Layton Show. My God, I know y'all miss me and all that good shit. I'm Alexa Layton, and I'm here with my girl.
Yes. Just Latasha, y'all.
Yes. And I'll snap. I don't know why I start snapping. This ain't poetry jam. But, well, first things first. Do you think Cardi B has already taken Offset back? It's 2019. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year,
y'all. You think she took him back already, bitch?
I think she's been riding that thing into the sunset in silence.
Okay. I feel like Christmas, she was riding dick.
Yeah.
New Year's, riding dick.
How can you not on New Year's? You have a child.
You know what I'm saying?
Come on.
She brought in that New Year with Offset's dick on her mouth, okay?
Just the way she wanted. Dreams do come true.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I feel like she wouldn't have it any other way. So good for you, Cardi. Unfortunately, I'm not supporting this. I think you should still drag him through the mud a little bit more. Wait till you win a Grammy.
It's just not realistic, babe.
You know what I'm saying? I know you wasn't rushing for a divorce, but I hope their prenup is in check. Like, I hope, you know, she ain't ending up like Toni Braxton or Mary J. Blige and giving him alimony if they go through a divorce. Because, honey, we know you got way more money than Offset does.
Cardi is cheaper to keep him, babe. Keep riding that dick into the sunset.
Or it's cheaper to be smart and have your lawyers draw up that good old contract that say you ain't getting shit if we break up. But on to more serious news. So New York City adds gender-neutral options to their birth certificates. It's 2019, and the transgender people are getting what they want. Adults over the age of 18 can now alter their birth certificates to say X rather than male or female without a doctor's note, so long as they attest via a form that the change is to reflect their true gender identity. Do you think this is a win for the transgender community?
I'm cisgender, so I probably shouldn't be speaking on this, but I hope it is a win for my trans community. You are loved. We love you so much. Gender reveal parties are still 2018, canceled, late, done, trash. We are letting our babies grow up and self-identify to the gender that they would like to align. And no more forcing old, tired caveman gender roles on precious, precious human beings. Let them be who they are.
I love it.
That's all I got.
Wonderful.
That's all I got.
I don't know if I'm ready to give up gender reveal parties. What? I didn't have a baby yet.
I didn't get my party yet.
A gender reveal. Why are you stealing this from me? Now, what powder do I throw in the air?
White. A gray white powder. Baby powder.
Like there's a fire or something.
Or someone's gonna smell real nice.
Okay, that's it. That takes all the fun out of gender reveals. We don't know. We're just gonna wait till they decide. But no, I do think it's a win for the transgender community. Y'all got the right to identify as what you want. I never understood the hoopla of trying to force people to be something that they don't identify with. If you identify as with a woman, then go ahead, you're a woman. If you identify as being a man, then be whatever you think a man is. I feel like people have the right to live their lives the way they want, and 2019 ain't trying to hold nobody back, okay? Because they ain't holding me back, all right? These niggas can't hold me back, and they can't hold y'all back either, all right? Moving on. Tommiee from Love and Hip Hop is reportedly been indicted on child abuse. She's facing up to 54 years in jail if convicted. Last October, Tommiee paid a visit to her daughter's middle school and for whatever reason ended up slapping her, dragging her by her hair through the hall, and shoving her into a metal locker. Do you think, given the circumstances of what she did to her child on school property, that the charges she's facing are valid?
Just about. Tommiee, so beautiful, so fine, so broken. We've watched this woman ruin her own life and self-sabotage because issues that she has inside have not been faced, addressed, healed. She really needs to find the help that she is looking for in all the wrong places. And child abuse is canceled. P- pedophilia's canceled, molestation's canceled. We're going to leave Black children alone, allow them to grow up healthily and safe and protected. And even though she's a great personality or whatever, she's had her fun, she's entertained us, this behavior has gotten out of hand, and I'm down with the 54 years.
Ooh, child, 54?
She's been detrimental to herself, her family, and her community. And now her baby? Don't feel sorry for her.
Honestly, I don't think 54 years is warranted, being that I've had that done, that and more done to me as a child. That turned out okay. But what I will say is
did
this.
Did we, sis? Did we?
No, we did. I grew up in a Jamaican household. We did. Okay? But I'm going to try to throw, you know, I try to throw my mama on the bus, but bitch.
Mama,
you know,
might need 13 years.
I think Tommy's daughter will be okay. But you know what? I'm not going to condone child abuse. I also feel like parents got to get more creative nowadays. There are more creative ways to chastise and punish your child. I don't know what Tommy's daughter did to deserve this. I don't think she deserved that in general. But whatever happened to waiting until you get home to beat your kid's ass, all right? And then also, I feel like people, we can get more creative. Like, I feel like whooping your kid's ass is, like, very barbaric, and it's just, like, so outdated as far as punishment goes. Like, there are ways to punish your child without beating the shit out of them. Like, make them wear Team Jordans or something. You know what I'm saying? Like,
make them wear what?
Team Jordans instead of the real Jordans. You know? Like, make them, you know what I'm saying? Make them wear something from, like, Goodwill to school. Make them wear the same outfit, like, 3 days in a row or something. Like, I feel like there's better ways than whipping your kid's ass. Like, that's just so archaic. Okay? Get more creative, parents. And also, are you trying to go to jail? Because 2019, the government ain't with that shit. All right? They will snatch your kid away. And I'd rather make my kid write a 5-page essay on why they were fucking up in class to get their phone back and Instagram access back, then whoop their ass and risk going to jail. Okay?
Okay, you landed in a good spot.
Let's do, like,
you know, started, man, you started here, started, and I was like, oh, no, had, oh, listen, no, we landed in a good spot.
I had good ideas,
you
just
good
had
spot.
To give me some time, you know what I'm saying? Let me lay them out.
She was like,
y'all.
Beat your kids in private, humiliate them in front of all their peers, write an essay. Let's land with writing an essay.
First of all, I don't think wearing Team Jordans is humiliating. I think it builds character. Not everybody has money to be fly. So now you're going to feel like the kids that ain't fly. And it's okay to feel like that. It builds character. Moving on. At what age would you let your child get an Instagram?
Seeing if I actually have human children rather than 13 cats in the future, I would estimate maybe like preteen, 12, 13, 14. I think social media is so scary. There's too much information, way too accessible, and too many strangers are too accessible to your child. And it's an uncontrollable medium. We used to have like AOL on CD. You remember that? You
don't? Yes.
Oh, I was like, I'm an old bitch out here now.
Floppy
and
disk.
You can, yes, you can control the websites that your kids can access, the set passwords to certain sites. Like, you can put limitations on the internet. Now, as soon as your kid has a phone, they can look at literally whatever they want. And that, to me, is pretty scary. So, as someone who doesn't have kids but looking forward to be a mom somewhere down the line, I would say preteen, but try to keep a strong relationship with your kid that you can keep an open form of communication and build trust with each other.
I like that. I'm not letting my kid have Instagram till they're 16.
Oh, okay.
16, yep.
It's what 16. Brought you to that conclusion?
Because I just feel like 10, 11, 12, those are just, you're too young, all right? You're too goddamn young. There's too much sex. There's too much cursing. There's too much weirdos on Instagram that will legit come to your profile, especially if you have high-profile parents. And they will literally come and bash you and tell you things like kill yourself and tell you things like your mom's a whore. And there's crazy people out there. They will say whatever. And kids are very impressionable. Okay. We all know this. It's just facts. Kids are very impressionable. And these things can invade their brains. I didn't grow up with Instagram, and I feel like that was a good thing. I feel like a lot of us didn't grow up with Instagram. And it helped us build character.
Yeah, you got bullied to your face.
You know what I'm saying? You got bullied to your face. You learn how to talk back to people. You learn how to defend yourself. And you know what I'm saying? With your words. and maybe a fist. You know, you didn't have to deal with like internet bullies and like, you know, these weirdo self-esteem issues that everyone has now. I mean, I'm not gonna say self-esteem issues didn't exist before, but I just feel like now online there's like these standards.
Intensified.
Yeah, that's intensified, and then these are standards that kids feel like they need to live up to, and it's nah. 16, sweetheart. All right, you'll be okay. Speaking of children, R. Kelly.
Oh, wait.
Girl. Oh, damn. You need help? Okay. Don't snatch your wig off now.
Oh, no. God, it happened again.
I hope it's glued down. Okay.
Oh, she's glued, baby.
Okay, she's glued.
Okay, there we go. Good Lord.
Speaking of children, though, R. Kelly is finally receiving the public crucifixion that he deserves. Okay? For raping and abusing underage girls. And after the 6-part Lifetime documentary Surviving R. Kelly aired last week, there were a plethora of shocking revelations. And in the documentary, one of the things that were revealed were that many of his raunchy hits were inspired by underage girls. You know, age ain't nothing but a number, seems like you're ready. So despite this, some are still claiming that they will still listen to his songs and that they can separate the artist from the music. I'm gonna go first on this one.
Please.
As far as separating the artist from the music, you can't, okay? The artist created the music. So how the hell are you gonna separate them? One wouldn't exist without the other. All right. And after watching this 6-part documentary, okay, where he was messing with 12-year-old girls and then proceeded to create an album called 12 Play, I am not going to listen to R. Kelly's music the same way. And anybody who claims that they can and they can separate it is just, I think you're lying. And I think you're also part of the problem. I think that you're enabling him. So just like his manager did and his assistant did and everyone that was around him, rounding up this young cattle for him to train, and it's just sick. Honestly, you've had R. Kelly's music in your repertoire for over a decade now. Let it go. You've heard Bump and Grind enough. You've heard You Remind Me of My Jeep enough, okay? You know all the words in your head. Sing it in your head if you have to, but let it go, okay? He's canceled! Go ahead.
I'm in love with you.
Cancel him!
When it comes to R. Kelly, I want to stop separating the art from the artist. I want to stop separating him from things. I actually want to congeal. I want to bring things together, yes, for him. I want to congeal R. Kelly and the FBI. I want to congeal R. Kelly and a life sentence. I want to congeal R. Kelly with like misery and sadness and terror in his personal life. Today's your birthday. I hope if you do get a cake, you just choke on all the juicy, sweet, fleshy pieces, and for some reason you try and you cry and you just can't get it out, and then all of a sudden the breath slips from you. I don't know where you'll end up. If you stop streaming his music, he stops being paid, and if he stops being paid, he can stop paying the cops to protect him, stop paying his entourage to protect him, stop paying his assistant to protect him, stop building these houses that house these sex victims, these underage sex victims. You stop his lifestyle so he can't continue to harm people with his power and his fame and his influence and his money. This is what created the monster. We were all a part of this monster all along. So if you try to play 12 Play or whatever the fuck he's made before, you continue to allow him to be the predator that harms black girls. So now it becomes your fault.
Thank you, okay? There were also a number of celebrities that refused to be part of the documentary for reasons that we may never know, some of which were probably because they knew of his actions and do not wish to incriminate themselves by, you know, stating their piece. Which leads me to ask you this. If you came across somebody in life who could basically make your life's desires come true, but their personal lives went against your moral values, would you still work with that person and get what you could get out of them? Or would you refrain and be like, nope, I'm gonna just figure this shit out on my own?
First of all, I'm afraid of change. So I know what it's like to be broke and struggling. That I'm comfortable with. As we can see, and let R. Kelly be a testament and example to us all, whatever you do in the dark comes to light. You've seen it with Bill Cosby, Harvey Weinstein, R. Kelly. It don't matter how long it takes, one day it's all gonna fall. And if you align yourself with someone who's gonna fall one day, everything that you've worked for and dreamed of will be taken away from you as well. And this is why celebrities are currently so quiet, because they know they're next in line when R. Kelly starts going down. So it's not worth it. It's not worth it. It'll be temporary. People will hate you. They'll hate your work. You'll lose everything that you worked for. You might as well wait for the right opportunity. And whatever is meant for you, can't no rich mogul be the only way that you're gonna get it. It don't even make sense.
I agree. I definitely feel like, you know, I mean, I feel like people could say, oh, I'd take the opportunity and then use my success to bring him down, but I just kind of feel like even that is,
those are like black ops, useless.
You know, useless. I feel like even that is like, come on, bro. I mean, like you said, he's not the only option. I feel like when you live life as righteous as you possibly can, you avoid shit like this. You avoid getting wrapped up into anything that could possibly paint you in a light that isn't, you know, what you would want people to see you in. People let money overpower morals and let money overpower basically what, which is just right from wrong. And it's sad as fuck. I'm gonna need y'all in 2019 to get y'all morals in order, okay? I'm gonna get y'all morals in order. Stop being assholes. Stop being dickheads. I'm gonna need y'all to, you know, maybe, do you need to read the Bible? Do you need to join a prayer group? Do you need to meditate? Do something to ground you and just ground you in righteousness and in love. All right, because I don't want to see this happen again. I don't want to see stories like this, where young women, black or white, are being abused. I don't wanna see any stories about young men, black or white, being abused. We need to protect the youth. So I just really feel like there's like no excuse for all the covering up and everything that went on with this whole R. Kelly debauchery. And speaking of R. Kelly, we actually have him here today. We've decided to invite R. Kelly to the couch, the Alexa Layton show, and sit down with him. And
where is he? Please bring him out.
Please bring to figure him out how he feels after watching this 6-part documentary, and just kind of get his intake. So let's go to the footage right now. Hey, Robert Kelly. Hi, I'm Alexa Layton.
I'm R. Kelly, and this is my life. This is my life. This is my life.
Okay. Your raunchier hits, like, seems like you're ready, is about taking an underage girl's virginity.
My music teacher, Lena McLean, she said, do not write songs. Write life. Sex is life. So don't judge me.
You're going to jail! Period! Sorry about that. Let me calm down. How do you sleep at night? Like how? How do you sleep?
Well, I'm fucking you tonight.
R. Kelly, don't play with me, cause I will beat your ass. You know what? Oh, child, it was so hard. trying to get through that, but I made it through. Thank you so much.
Thank you, girl.
Put the earrings back on. Yo, thank you.
Thank God, because I thought he was here.
You know, thank you for having my back. You know what I'm saying? Thank you for coming to the show today.
Thank you.
Any last remarks?
Fuck you, R. Kelly.
Fuck
that's,
R. Kelly.
That's all I have on my heart. Please pass your phone to whoever could read your tweets for you. I've been tweeting you day in and day out, and I really want you to get the message. Fuck you with the long dick.
A sick dick.
Fuck you with the long dick. Catch me on Aurore TV, just Latasha. Thank you for having me, Alexa.
Yes, no problem. Last remarks from me are, Meek Mill, shut the fuck up, all right? We are not canceling lace fronts in 2019. It's not going to happen.
It'll never happen.
I understand you had a traumatic experience. You know, you was hitting it from the back, went to go grab some shorty hair, and it came off. That's regular, okay? That's regular. What you should have did was ask her before you touched her hair, all right? I'm tired of the disrespect, okay? Y'all need to stop being so entitled to you don't ask somebody. Ask the question, can I touch your hair? Is it gonna move? Is it gonna come off? Is she glued down? Is she sewed down? You know what I'm saying? All you gotta do is ask a couple questions and you can avoid traumatizing experiences like that. But you know what? Honestly, that's regular, okay? We're not giving up lace fronts. Honey, it's a $1 billion industry. We're not giving up the hair, all right? It's just not gonna happen. So stop spewing the hate and the negative rhetoric online, okay? Lace fronts ain't going nowhere, 2019. All right, hashtag that.
It's supposed to be a light tug.
Anyways, make sure you guys tune into the Alexa Layton Show every week. Follow us on Twitter, on Instagram, and subscribe. Thanks. See y'all next week.
Shoe hands.
Yes. Ooh, and shoe hands.
Oh.